गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णु गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परब्रह्मा तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। ओं सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनामधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ओं शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। Keep your mind and heart in Param Guru Paramatma. Let us seek our great gurus for their blessings to attain the knowledge of yoga. And let us thank all our gurus who have given us the great knowledge of yoga. With us, let us surrender to the Almighty. Keep both hands in Adi Mudra. Keep at your back, inhale, bend back, exhale, bend down. Surrender the body, mind, and intellect. Slowly, Ishvara Pranda. Slowly come back. Then you touch your arms. Okay, so before we start, let me share some of the important stuff which we need to know. So as you all know, the yoga, you'll hear different kinds of yogas, and people generally confused with the number of varieties and things like that. But to make it very simple and easy, and for the understanding of everyone, let us make the things. Can you make me as co-host so that I can share my screen? So one of the important things we can do to understand it a bit more is today is a very special day. I wish you all a very happy International Yoga Day, and also today is a very special day, which is Amavasya, is no moon day with the solar eclipse. On this auspicious day, having this 24 hours yoga day celebration, it's very unique way the Manvata volunteers across the globe has been doing, with a wonderful handover between them. It's a great teamwork and inspiration to many volunteers and young people with such a selfless work. So one of the important things we need to understand here, the Karma Yoga. First of all, unless we have the heart to feel and the realize the purpose, yes, we need to do something good for others. We need to do something useful and purposeful to this world. So when you have that kind of a mindset, then automatically your driving is different. But many people confuse, basically the motivation behind the life, the people running behind the money and behind the material. So that makes the people more vulnerable to the diseases, vulnerable to the unhappiness. So now coming to the system of yoga, the very first thing is surrender, Ishvara Pranidhana. That's why we did bending forward and surrendering to the Almighty. And what is that surrender means? It is basically giving our body and mind and our energies for the selfless cause, for the divine cause. What is a divine cause? What is actually the purpose which God wants us to do? Doing good. Doing good and being good is our religion, as Swami Vivekananda says. That is our religion. There is no other religion in this world. Humanity is our identity. We all is one. So we, in terms of bringing this the whole culture of yoga, so we must understand it is not just hurry-burryly doing some asanas and doing some exercises. No, that is not the purpose. The purpose is creating, the bringing the happiness, and you become the happiness, and you become the light to everyone. So you are such a great, the bright light. You are such a happiness. And when you are there around, if you are able to make, create the health, create the happiness, and create the harmony around the 3H, automatically you are becoming towards achieving the state of yoga and adopting the style of yoga, yoga lifestyle, and sharing this thing for the purpose of dharma, the righteousness. So bringing the whole purpose of this life is to protect the dharma, to lead the righteousness, to achieve the satya, the truth, the true knowledge. So we should, an objective side, we should be very clear. Clear definition in terms of target, not a small things like, okay, I should gain the health and small things. Anyway, you get it. Those are byproducts. But mainly the goal we all should must have is the self-realization is the highest goal. Knowing thyself. Know thyself, you know everything. So that is why we must try hard, try working on inner self, going inward journey. So now understanding the limbs of yoga, now you have practiced the wonderful way of doing warming up your body with the sukshma vyayamas, which Kumar Garu has taught. And I appreciate Kishore Garu, Kumar Garu, and all the Ashburn team. You are doing a wonderful service, especially motivating people towards the healthy lifestyle and sharing this yoga knowledge with the practice, daily practice. It's a great service. So I should say, once you start adapting and you are able to make yourself and your children to start practicing, and also your friends to start practicing yoga regularly, that's a good achievement. So take those who are not able to make every day, or bargaining like once in a week, or three days a week, or something like that. So if you are eating three times, do three times yoga, and eat like yogic way, healthy food. So that is why here you can see yama, niyama, asana, pranayama, pratyahara, dharana, dhyana, samadhi. Try to achieve all that in day-to-day practice. Try to implement the principles of yoga, yama, niyamas, and principles of asana practice, which is a disciplined way of sthiram, chiram, sukham, asanam. The bringing that constant and stability within every movement of your body. And being aware of every movement of your body. That is asana practice. Just being aware. And being aware of your breath. And connecting the body and the mind with the help of the breath. That is by synchronizing the movements with the breathing. So that is why here the sequence is given. Niyama, niyama. So first start the condition. Body cleaning. Mind cleaning, then you are eligible to do the rest of the things. So not merely a physical exercise. Many people in the world, yoga means they think that it is only a physical exercise. So then they start doing like a physical yoga. It is not much beneficial. Of course, you get the physical, some physical benefit, but it's not much beneficial. You get only a 1%. But if you want to get 100% the fruits of yoga, you should start with yama niyamas, and the slowly adopt the limbs of all the 8 limbs of yoga, and achieve that dhyana sthiti and meditation state and the samadhi sthiti, complete liberation. Okay, so Here, pratyahara is another important aspect. Pranayama, you must be doing some of the types of pranayamas, but every breath be aware. Every breath make it deeper. And every physical movement make it with consciousness and awareness. Not only just in, during the practice, but during the practice, you are training your mind to be aware. Next is about, of course, you try to make these five principles as mandatory in your life. Make this oath as part of your life, especially in the non-violence, non-violent of way of eating, non-violent of way of thinking, talking, and in action. Let us live non-violently. Ahimsho paramo dharmaha. That is a important principle, most important principle. And the truth, the satya. Let us speak truth, let us think truth, and let us do truth, truthful action. And non-violent, non-stealing is celibacy, and let us make the commitment to stay away from the material cravings and material attachments. So that is most important. That is why Abhyasa Vairagya is a basic requirement for yoga. And what that is initially you may not achieve, but by practice of Raja Yoga, it's a wonderful way to start adopting and getting the control over your body and the mind. But regularity is important. That is why we started the 41 days Diksha. Those who are taking you 41 days continuously do it, automatically you can achieve the perfection. You can retain the practice. Okay, so and then non-accumulation is another important thing. Basically, people are just accumulating a lot of things. So what, unless you really need it, don't buy it. Anything, any extra, even one cloth is also an additional burden, and not only for your maintenance, but also to the Mother Earth. So let us not accumulate anything. Let us not encourage the gifting culture. The only gift is giving the health is a gift. And giving the truthfulness, giving the inspiration, those are the gifts. So let us take that culture, take these oaths, these five principles in your life. And those five principles you must take with the wholeheartedly, okay? So anyway, let us go into the practice session. Before going to the practice session, I will also share one more important presentation, which is about asanas. We are doing asana practice, right? In the physical postures, you try to do your with the prayerfully, always. Sahana vavatu, we do. Why? Because unless you connect to yourself and the guru, you cannot really learn the techniques of yoga. So the real knowledge will not come to. So you may be knowing there's some intellectual, some knowledge, but it is not enough. So you have to attain the spiritual knowledge. So similarly, closing prayer also, we try to do. So this is Patanjali Maharshi prayer. So initially, I think anyway, you have done all these sokshmayamas, which is good, breathing exercises, some of the warm-ups you did, which is good, which Kumar Garu has already taught. So apart from that, Tadasana, he was just teaching, but Tadasana and the relaxation position is Siddhila Tadasana, that itself is a great posture. Let us start practicing with the Tadasana. Come to Tadasana. Legs together, hands together. all the fingers pointing downwards. Take a deep breath. Make the standing posture straight, absolutely straight. Slowly inhale and take your hands upwards. So now let's do the Tadasana stretch. Okay, lock your fingers and stretch. Stand on your toes. Inhale up, exhale down. So do it again. When you're going up, inhale. Exhale down. Switch on your cameras. Let us practice together. Exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. This is called Tiryak Tadasana. Make sure that you bend only the lateral bending, straight bending, okay? And then feel the stretch here. Feel the stretch here. Experience it. Inhale. Slowly come back. So this is one of the important asanas which you can adopt as part of the life, which is the day-to-day. When you have a stress, you try to remove the stress from your body and mind. So take a break for 1 minute in your work. In between your work, you can go out just quickly, just to stretch for three breathings upwards and the stretch, and three breathings sideward, Tiryak Tadasana. So adopt this, make 3-4 times a day, maybe before lunch, before in the evening food, but before food you try to do this asana. It is very, very helpful for the people who are sitting longer hours and working in offices, especially IT people and also the doctors, whoever is sitting and working longer time, we must do a stretch. And as soon as you get up also, you try to do the this kind of a stretch. And making the yoga culture of life. How to make the asanas as part of the culture. Okay, let us do it meaningfully. Asanas practicing meaningfully means, okay, let us see in the Tadasana. Okay, standing balance, complete balance. So make sure that you be aware, both legs, the equally distributing your weight. So your weight is distributed equally on both legs. Observe and be aware. And slowly, slightly bend forward, whole weight, keep on your toes. Whole weight on toes. Experience is the pointed awareness. And slowly come to center and bend backwards. You keep your weight on the heels. Come to center. Now slowly bend on the right. Right side of your whole weight is right side of your right foot. And slowly just lean on the left. Experience the linear awareness on the left side of your left foot. Now come to center. So within that slow movement, within that single movement, you see lot of changes in your body. But when you are doing the physical movements, lot of works outside, unnecessarily so many physical actions will happen. So when you are able to practice this awareness, you will not do anything unnecessary. So once you avoid the unnecessary things from your life, unnecessary physical movements, unnecessary words, unnecessary thoughts, then when you are removed these things, all this nonsense will go away from your life. You become purified. So that is the object to one of the first step and object to of the yoga, the purification of the body and the mind. So with that, the purification, the practice the asanas with the awareness. Every asana, whatever the asana you do, Utkata asana, let's see. Chai pose. Come to the thighs parallel to the ground. Stay there. With a normal breathing. See, there is a, even if it is a painful, stressful, stay there, no problem. Just be patient. And if you can't stay close, you can just keep it a little bit apart and make a chai pose. Be aware with the normal breathing, okay? You can feel the pressure at your knees and thighs. Stay there. Slowly come up. And now see the different changes in your body. This is a great asana for your immune system. Not only immune system, for your spiritual development and overall health, it's a great asana, Utkata asana. So in the one Utkata asana, when you practice the Utkata asana, so in case if you have a body pains, what to do? All you need to do is, in the Utkata asana, you try to hold the fingers like that, okay? Cross the fingers, try to be in the Utkata asana, press. Press all these points in between your fingers. Exhale and press in here. Exhale and press. And back. Be there in the Utkata asana. Look back. And try to hold other side. Turn. And open up your hands. Look up. Slowly come back. Now see the power. So you get so much of thigh power. Just within 1 minute. So similarly, you adopt this 1 minute simple techniques. Like for example, with a Tadasana you did, stretch. 1 minute technique, that you can make it part of life. And another 1 minute technique, Utkatasana, this all your body pains can be cured without any painkillers. It's a wonderful asana. So that way, try to make as part of your day-to-day life. And the next, let us practice. Another divine pose and balance the pose. Hold a left leg like that. Hold your left leg. Try to balance on single leg first. So, are you able to do? See that you are able to do it. Hold it tightly like that. And similarly, practice the other leg also. Sometimes you feel left leg is not much balanced. Okay, now let us go into the Natarajasana. Kick your leg. When you dare, kick your leg and make the hand parallel to the ground. And similarly, other hand also parallel to the ground. Look forward. This is the Lord Shiva's position, Natarajasana. Feel Lord Shiva within you. Trayambakam Vijamahe Sugandhim Pushtivardhanam Urvarukumeva Vandhanan Mrityor Mukshiyam Amritat. Stay there without any movement. Slowly come back. Now come to Sidra Tadasana, relax and observe the changes. This observation is very important. So when you do the Yogasana, after warm up, you can start the Yogasana. But when you do the asana, you must make sure you are giving the relaxation in between and observing changes. Be aware of the changes in your body.
Next, the second slide. Slide change, other leg. Kick your leg back, switch. Another hand, you make it chin mudra. Give a nice switch. Be there. Feel Lord Shiva within. Feel the divinity within. Om Trayambakam Yajamahe Sugandhim Pushtivardhanam Purvarukmyo Vandanam Mrityor Mrikshiyam Amrutatam. Relax. Close your eyes and observe the head to toe and toe to head, the whole body. Every cell, don't miss anything. Every cell you observe, what changes you see. Every part, you can see different changes. Left side, it is different. Right side, stimulation is different. Observe it. And then relax every part of the body. This is the tada. Once you've done it, come to sit. Sit tada. So another divine posture. Why I'm saying they are divine postures? These are the postures which you must feel God within, the divinity within. The connecting to the integrating, the, as I said, the yoga is union of the self with the supreme self, the Paramatma. So how do you do that? By basically bringing it together, like the having that bhavana. First thing is having bhavana. In every asana, have that consciousness. Don't forget that every asana you must feel. Every asana you must feel so relaxed and so divine. So what bhavana you should have in your heart? You should have a bhakti. So let's do Garuda asana. Right and left leg. Turn over right leg. And keep your right hand side and then left hand turn over the left hand over right. Garuda asana. Feel that you are carrying Lord Vishnu. So this will remind the meaning of this asana. The purpose of this body is to carry on God's duty, the divine duty. It is not just eating, sleeping, or drinking and enjoying or doing parties. It is to duty, do the duty of God every second of our life. Remember, you are carrying Lord Vishnu on your shoulder. Garuda is a vehicle for Lord Vishnu. So feel the divinity within. Feel the power. The great asana to make your legs and hands strong, especially the wings, the hands. You get rid of all the shoulder pains, back pains, neck pains, spondylitis. So great asana. So feel prayerfully you do this asana. Prayerfully, praying with Lord Vishnu, like how Hanuman is always Sri Ram, Sri Ram, Sri Ram. Have that devotion, great power. So that devotion brings the power. It is not the physical exercise. It is about the devotion. Your heart and the mind brings the power. So now, right leg over left leg. First, bring the right leg over left leg. Now keep the left hand side. And right hand over left. If you can't do balance, just take the support like that at the round and try to do it. But balance it, try to balance. Stay there. Vishwam Vishnu Vasatkaro Bhuta Bhavya Bhavat Prabhu Bhuta Bhuta Buddhavo Bhuta Atma Bhuta Bhavanaha Bhuta Atma Paramatma Mukta Nam Paramagadhi योगो योग विधामेता प्रधान पुरुषेश्वरः. Feel the changes. Close your eyes. come to Siddhartadasana. Observe the changes in the entire body. Feel the dignity and power in your shoulders and entire body. Feel that you are carrying Lord Vishnu within your shoulder. Garuda, the strongest bird in the world. So that way, every asana has brought a great meaning in it. It is not a physical one. So try to understand the inner meaning and practice it with the bhavana. That bhavana is very vyadbhavam tad bhavati. So you must understand the culture of the mind. Understand the importance of your thoughts. You become whatever you think. So that is why your thoughts are very powerful. So try to cultivate the divinity within. Cultivate your mind with the divine thoughts. So by practice of asana. Okay, so one more important step I am going to tell. One single asana. So these days, you're all talking about the immune system. So everyone wants to improve their immunity. How do you improve immunity with the yoga? Of course, in every practice, asana, pranayama, all these practices improve immunity. The practice of yoga itself is a cure for everything, healing for everything. There's no other medicine required. It's only just yoga, with yoga, with pranayama, you can treat everything. So everything is, yeah, the amazing power is there. Yeah. That's the power of yoga. So how do you actually start your day? So one of the important aspects to purify the mind and heart, first of all, cultivate the feeling of gratitude. So that gratitude is very important. That is why we do the namaskara. So who is eligible to take the first namaskara? Master Devo Bhava. First we have to namaskara. As soon as you get up, pray Mother. And bring the pure love, selflessness. Pray, Father. Bring that responsibility. And pray, Guru. Guru at Ajna Chakra. Get the knowledge. And thank Guru for giving us great knowledge. Seek the blessing. Inhale. Take up, and then next is the who is giving the food, and all the life is she carrying Mother Earth. This is Father Hastasana, and bring that high patience and selflessness from Mother Earth. Inhale, bend back. The source of energy, namaskar to the sun. Bring the thanks, sun, for giving us the life and the energy. And thanks all around. Do the namaskara properly. Respect all. What it means, saying the gratitude to all. We are taking the oxygen from the trees. We are taking the so much resources from the nature, but we must thank Mother Nature, we must protect Mother Nature, and we must make sure that we love nature, we care nature, and we must make sure that we are not spoiling Mother Earth, Mother Nature with our action. So let us lead a life, eco-friendly life. That is why for yoga, eco-friendly life is very, very essential. So yoga practitioner means we live responsibly. We live eco-friendly. We live healthy. So that is a practice we get. We live healthy. There is no medicine required. Last 20 years, we are not taking any medicine. No medicine required. That is the style of yoga lifestyle. So yukta ahara viharasya yukta chesta shukarma. So whatever you do with the consciousness, given the wise way of selecting the food, okay, and wise way of doing this. And for the immune system, one more simple breathing exercise I will tell. Okay, the thymus gland. Kneel down. Come to kneel down position. Come to kneel down position like that. Okay, left hand keep it on your right armpit, and right hand left armpit, and keep both thumbs in between. So look for a bump in between, exactly in between chest, where the thymus gland is there, and press both thumbs in between. Inhale, bend back. Exhale completely, push your lungs down. Inhale, exhale, down. Inhale, up. Exhale, complete exhale. That's it. Just the lower lungs down. Inhale. Okay, so the thymus activation helps you to improve your T cells. So T cells, and they two important things to remember. One is T cells, and second is B cells bone marrow. Okay, so for bone marrow, we will do some simple pranayama. I'm not sure whether you all have practiced the Surya Namaskara. Let us do two rounds of Surya Namaskara before you close, because this is very auspicious day of sun. It is Sunday, at the same time you also have a solar eclipse, and this is also a very auspicious day. So let us practice Surya Namaskara, just two rounds. So come to Siddhi Tadasana, and then Pranamasana. किरण्मयेन पात्रेण सत्यशापी तन्मुखम तत्त्वं पोषन् अपाहृणु सत्यधर्माय दृष्टये ॐ राम मित्राय नमः. Be clear of your objective. The objective of this sadhana is to attain the truth and the righteousness in our life, the true knowledge. So we are praying Lord Sun to open up that golden lid to show us the truth and righteousness. Stand in the front of the mat. Inhale. Astha Uttanasana. Exhale. Bend forward. Padmasana. Try to keep legs straight, knees straight. Chin on the chest. Exhale. Inhale. Left leg back. Look up. Astha Sanchalanasana. Give a nice stretch here. Look up. Touch your both palms down. Adho Mukha Svanasana, mountain pose, Parvatasana. Try to touch both heels on the ground. Give a nice stretch at your shoulders. Sashankasana. Exhale. Come forward, Ashtanga, chin and chest on the ground. Inhale. Look up, exhale. Mountain pose. Touch your feet completely on the ground. Wonderful asana to strengthen your lungs and hands. And great asana to improve your memory and concentration. And good for the immune. Now right, left leg forward, look up. Pada Hastasana. Hastavatasana, inhale. Exhale. Om Hrim Ravaye Namaha. Do the complete devotion at your heart, concentration at your mind. In between eyebrows, bright sun. Inhale. Exhale. Now right leg back, look up. Touch your palms on the ground. Make a nice stretch. Great asana for your thyroid, neck. Parvatasana. Sashanka. Come to Ashtangasana. Wonderful asana for your activating for your thymus and thyroid, or immune. Get rid of all the throat infections, chest infections. Super asana for your respiratory system. Inhale, look up. Next year, once before. Feel wonderful stretch at your shoulders. Now right leg forward, look up. Touch your palms completely on the ground, look up. Pada Hastasana. Stay there. Mountain pose, yeah, and Hastavastanasana. Namaskara. So we did two rounds of Surya Namaskara. Siddha Tadasana, relax, feel the sun energy throughout your body, close your eyes. So like that, today, two times already 108 Surya Namaskara is done. In India and Singapore team, the East Coast, we did all 108 Surya Namaskara, one round of Yogatan. And then UK team has done another 108 Surya Namaskara challenge, inspired so many children. So like that, you also inspire all the people around you and bring in more people to practice yoga from this day. Let more people take the commitment and oath to adopt the yoga as part of their practice. This is a great gift you can give to your friends. Okay, come to sitting bush. Come to sitting position. Okay, another important asana I will explain you, which is very helpful for your physical health and also your nervous system. Apart from that, spiritual growth. Okay, take your left leg onto the left heel. Keep it at the perineum and make your foot onto the thigh like that. What is this called? Utkatasana. Inhale, look up, stretch, exhale, down, hold it. Stay there with normal breathing. Wonderful asana to activate your mind, to bring the excellence, to bring the right knowledge, stability, to cure insomnia, all the mind related problems. Inhale, come back. Exhale, slowly down. Come to Siddha Dandasana, relax. Observe changes, entire body, head to toe and toe to head. Always remember to scan your body before moving to the next asana and observe the changes, what happened, should be aware of what is the change before and after this asana. Okay, next, the right leg onto the left thigh and hold heel under your perineum. Inhale up, exhale down. Try to touch your head on the knee. Janu means knee. Shirsha means head. Keeping the head on the knee. Inhale up, exhale down. So bringing that head onto the knee makes your spiritual sadhana well, and it also helps you to attain the right knowledge through activating your brain, left brain and right brain through this. It is mainly to work with the brain. Janu Shirshasana. So, you know, in Telugu there is a saying, Madhura Mokallo Unnandu. So there are some people, they won't have common sense. Many people in this world, many people do not have common sense. To bring the common sense and to bring the right knowledge, Janu Shirshasana is one of them. Everyone must do. So if you are not able to do, try to practice it few days, 1 month, you target it. Everyone should have a goal. Everyone must have goal in your life. Forget about all around. You are the person, you are the human life. You have a purpose and realize your purpose. Have that goal, know your goal and try to reach your goal. Don't confuse with the worldly stuff and try to understand more about your goal and make a target. Even in yoga also, when you do the stretches. So for example, if you are doing this stretch, Pachimottana stretch, how much you can do? So you have this much gap now, so you can slowly target it. Where there is a will, there is a way. So when you have a target, you can do it. Okay, next is Baddha Konasana, like that. Butterfly. Okay, see, this is another important asana, especially for the women. In pregnant women also, it is one of the must asanas to do. Inhale, exhale, Baddha Konasana, the butterfly. Inhale down. Try to touch your head on the ground. So this is also very important. If you are unable to touch, see what is your measurement. You can do it. Someday you can achieve that. But slowly you can practice it with the consciousness. Exhale. Whatever your stretch, doesn't matter. Try to do your best. Inhale. Exhale down. Inhale up. Okay? And then take your right leg onto the left thigh. Left leg onto the right thigh. If you can't do the Padmasana, do the Ardha Padmasana, at least like that. Just try to do Padmasana. Learn this Padmasana. It's wonderful asana for your sadhana. So it makes you like live like a lotus. The meaning of this asana is, though you are living in a dirty world, the unethical or unsafe world, you should be, you know, the lotus is in the dirty water, but still it blossoms beautiful. Similarly, we all must live without touching this dirt, without touching these sins. We must be pure at our heart. We must be pure in our life. So that is what the Padmasana meaning. And also it brings you a lot of mind control to make yourself pure and to live with the purity. So that's why I try to bring the Padmasana and sit at least 15 to 20 minutes every day and meditate in Padmasana. So you need to have one meditation asana. And make your sitting posture correct. With the hands back, you can practice this. Even if you can't hold, no problem, but try to keep the hands back. Try to hold it or try to place, bend back, make your spinal straight. So normally people have a sitting disorder that can be corrected through this asana. Baddha Padmasana is a great asana to bring the proper sitting posture, make your spinal correction and remove your back pain. And slowly bend down, like see, inhale up. Next, we'll come back. So you can feel so much of energy flow throughout your shoulders. You can observe. So that way, these stretching things are very, very important. And every asana, know the meaning of it, practice meaningfully, live meaningfully. Every step you do, take meaningfully. Without purpose, there should not be anything. That's why first we have to know the purpose and take the steps. In life or in yoga sadhana, everywhere. Yoga is itself is a lifestyle. That's why this tells us to live with the consciousness, live with the awareness, live with the purpose, live with the meaning. Okay, both hands in chin mudra. Neck and spinal. Right. Relax your shoulders. Keep a beautiful smile on your face. Take a deep breath. Keep your concentration in between eyebrows. Exhale slowly. Complete exhalation. Inhale deeply. One exhalation and one inhalation, deep inhalation is called one laghu pranayama. Continue. Few more rounds with a deeper breathing and with awareness. Use your maximum capacity of your lungs. Be aware of the prana. Prana is everything. Prana is not only in just this body, but it presents the whole universe. Let us pray that prana, prayerfully receive that prana shakti, the deeper breathings, with inner awareness. Prana shedham vache sarvam tridiveyat pratishtitam. मातेनु पुत्रस्य रक्षस्व श्रीच प्रज्ञाच विदेहिनैति. Pray that prana, as universal energy, the whole universe is under control of prana. Prana will take care of us like how mother takes care of child. Prana gives us the health, wealth, the real wealth, the knowledge, the prajna. There is true knowledge. So such is the prana. So everything is under control of prana. That is why in pranayama is most important, which you need to be aware every moment of your life, every moment of your yoga practice, yoga sadhana, asana practice. Take a deep, maintain deeper breathing. At least 5 minutes you do this, the full yogic breathing, the laghu pranayama. Very simple breathing, but it gives you so much of energy within short time. So whenever you get time in your travel, you're waiting something, try to close your eyes and do the laghu pranayama.
and then continue with the breath awareness, the meditation. One more round, take a deep breath. Akar, ukar, makara. Ah. Feel the Omkara vibrations, entire body, head to toe, and toe to head. Feel that divinity within every cell of your body, vibrating with Om, 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 all over. Bring that purity, make a divine body. The pure body, the sound body, and mind completely placed onto that Om, meaning of Om, means Paramatma, the God. Omnipresent, omniscient, and omnipotent. Immortal, infinite, Satchitananda Swarupa. The universally present. Have that universal consciousness. Merge with the Supreme Self. You become that infinite. You are that whole universe, Purnatva. You are that fulfillment. You are that Sivoham. Not this body. Merge yourself into that Supreme. Experience the infinite nature of this self, the purity. You are that happiness. Experience the Dhyana Sthiti, the meditation state at the highest conscious level, consciousness, supreme consciousness. Forget this all temporary things, body and the material. Merge with that comment. Om Bhurbhuvah Tat Savitur Varenyam Vargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yonah Prachodayat. Om Sarve
भवन्तु सुखिनः सर्वे सन्तु निरामयाः सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु मा कश्चित् दुःखभाग् भवेत् ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः लोका समस्ता सुखिनो भवन्तु सर्वे जना सुखिनो भवन्तु May all beings happy and peaceful. May you all gain health, happiness, and harmony. And share this universal love and 3H to all around. Let us together heal this world. Let us together share our energies to remove the sorrows and miseries of all beings. Keep both hands at your back. Hold your right wrist with left hand. Inhale, bend back. Exhale, bend down. Yogi Mudrasana. Ishvara Pranidhana. Surrender to Almighty. Body, mind and intellect. Complete surrender. This is most important asana. With the bhavana of complete saranagati. Surrender. Relieves all the stress. It removes all the negative thoughts, negative emotions, hatred, anger, greed, lust, jealous, cravings, aversions, ego, attachments, all that you remove and liberate yourself. Be happy. Be peaceful. Complete surrender. Slowly come back with inhalation. Feel complete peace in you. Slowly, gently rub your hands, press on the palms on your eyes. Feel complete peace. Gently open your eyes and look at your palms. Let us use these powerful and holy hands for a great purpose. Let us not waste our life, our time for unnecessary things. Make every minute, every second useful, peaceful, purposeful, meaningful. Let us lead our life meaningfully with health, happiness, and harmony. Wish you all the best. And may God bless you with that 3H. Thank you. Wish you all the best. Thank you all. And thanks particularly to all the Ashbourne team and all the practitioners who have joined and the Vedanta Society, especially Kishore Garu for taking the responsibility from the East Coast to organize this 24-hour Yoga Day event for the Manavata team. And also Kumar Garu for taking the responsibility of spreading this yoga knowledge. Thank you all, one and all. All the volunteers and everyone who are bringing energies together to save this world, to help others. Thank you all.
Thank you. Thank you, Srini Garu. I think Pramod Garu is already on from Vedanta Group.
Any questions from anyone? Actually.